Computer inventory records contain a plethora of information for Jamf Pro administrators, from the last time they checked in with the server to their operating system build and version, installed apps, and more. Most of this information is updated automatically when a computer submits inventory to Jamf Pro. Anything that isn't updated can usually be customized manually by an administrator. From an inventory record, remote commands can be issued to a Mac to quickly update settings like Bluetooth, lock or wipe the device if they are lost or stolen, or force a software update. My name is Zach. Welcome to Computer Inventory and Remote Commands. Let's take a look at a computer inventory record. Starting from the dashboard, navigate to Computers, Search Inventory, and search for an enrolled computer. Select its name to access the inventory record. An inventory record is comprised of three tabs: Inventory, where all the information about the computer is organized; Management, where we can issue new commands and view what management tasks are scoped to the computer from Jamf Pro; and History, where we can view what management tasks successfully or unsuccessfully have run on the computer. In the Inventory tab, there's a list of categories on the left to organize all the data Jamf Pro has on record for this computer. The general category contains the computer name and some important management data points: last inventory update, last check-in, management status, enrollment method, and more. While we won't go in-depth into each of these data points, keep in mind that two of the most important pieces of information on this page are the last inventory update, or how old is the data on this page, and last check-in, or when did this computer last contact Jamf Pro. For more information on each item in a computer inventory record, check out the documentation linked in the resources titled Computer Inventory and Criteria Reference. Moving on, the hardware category contains physical information about the computer, such as make and model. For example, this computer is a 13-inch MacBook Pro. It also contains specific identifying information about this Mac, like the serial number, unique device identifier or UDID, and MAC address, among others. The operating system category displays what version and build of macOS the computer has installed. The user and location category can be populated manually or as part of a pre-stage enrollment, allowing us to track what user is assigned to this computer as well as other data points like department or building. Security reports whether system integrity protection is enabled as well as other security data like gatekeeper and activation lock statuses. The applications category details every app that is installed in an applications directory on the computer, at both the system and user levels. There are several additional categories here, and we encourage you to explore each of them for a comprehensive understanding of the data collected from your users' computers. Some inventory information can be updated manually. Let's return to the general category and select Edit in the top right corner of this pane. Not every field is able to be customized since they are automatically populated by the computer during inventory submission. However, we can still add useful information here, like an asset tag for this Mac. If I'm setting up a cart of MacBooks for a classroom and have an asset tag sticker on each of them, I can manually enter that information in this field to track it in Jamf Pro. After entering the asset tag, be sure to click Save in the top right before navigating away from this page. The user and location data is also modifiable. Select the user and location category and edit in the top right. I'm going to add this computer to the Minneapolis building. Again, click Save in the top right. Now, if we return to the Computers tab and search for Minneapolis, our computer will show up among the other computers belonging to this building. Let's select the computer record once more and explore the available remote commands in the Management tab. The commands shown here will vary based on the computer's management status and enrollment method. In this case, since this computer is managed and was enrolled through a pre-stage enrollment, all commands are available. The lock command will log out the user, restart the computer, and set a firmware-level passcode on the Mac that will need to be entered before the computer can be used again. This is a security measure that is typically used for lost or stolen computers. We can remove the MDM profile, preventing the computer from receiving future remote commands and configuration profiles, wipe the OS and all data from the computer, which also locks it with a passcode, download available updates, and more. Send blank push will send a blank management command to the computer. Think of it like receiving a stamped and addressed, but empty, envelope in the mail. This can be deployed to computers as a quick troubleshooting method to ensure they are receiving commands from Jamf Pro, without needing to actually specify an action for the computer to take. Below, we can see a history of pending commands, which have been deployed but not yet applied, and commands that have been deployed but have failed to register on the computer. These we may want to try redeploying. Remote commands can also be sent to multiple computers at once. Navigate back to the Computers tab, and let's search for all Minneapolis computers once more. Click the Action button in the lower right to access Mass Actions. From here, we can deploy various actions to every computer in our search results, in this case, all computers in the Minneapolis building. We used a simple inventory search in this example, but mass actions can be issued to advanced searches, static groups, and smart groups as well. We can change the building or department, send an email to associated users if they have an email address in their user and location data, and send remote commands. Select Send Remote Commands and click Next. Some of the options here mirror those we found in the Management tab for a single computer record: lock, set Bluetooth, and software update, among others. Remember that the commands selected here will affect every computer in the search results or group you selected, so be cautious and double-check your work before clicking Next. That's all for our lesson on computer inventory and remote commands. Computer inventory records are an invaluable tool for maintaining awareness of the state of your enrolled computers. If a computer has issues, the options to remotely secure, update, or manage those Macs are readily available through remote commands and mass actions. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in another video.